Hi, my name is Annalisa Moore, and I'm the lead facilitator for Nea Community Learning Center, where we serve children grades kindergarten through 12th. In this video, you will see learners, parents, and facilitators talking about the elements that really make our program a successful place for children to learn and grow. Some of the things that they will discuss are around our project-based learning model, which provides hands-on inquiry-based learning that helps to engage children as well as meet the Common Core state standards. We balance academic rigor with the development of social-emotional skills through our Second Step curriculum and restorative justice.
There are two things here at NEA that I think are very special that show up every day, and one is the community and the culture for the families in our small school feeling, and the other is the ability that the facilitators have the freedom to write their own curriculum for their specific class as well as their specialty. Because of our rotation, we're really able to meet the kids' needs and change up lessons to go faster as needed if the class is ready to move on, to change things if the class is more interested in something that they want to learn more about. We can do that, and that's what makes me a special place.
One of the most exciting and worthwhile endeavors is that as a facilitator here at NEA, you get to really kind of carve out avenues, curriculum development, etc., that are interesting to you, that you feel passionate about. You're allowed to have some of your personal, your heart, your personal investment, your love, your the things that make you excited as a professional. You're allowed to let those things spill over into your teaching and into the curriculum that you develop for your learners. And when you have that kind of excitement and you have that kind of passion around what you're doing, it's contagious. And in this line of work, that's such a positive thing, because what you are able to bring to the table is reflected back in our learners. And what's even more exciting about being at NEA is that you have learners that you work with at different grade levels. I have 11th graders that I've worked with as middle schoolers. I get to see and interact with these young people at different stages in their lives, and they get to see and interact with an adult figure, a teacher who is consistent throughout these developmental years. And that's so important, so valuable for them, because you're actually able to develop and grow and nurture these relationships. And when you have that kind of foundation, it makes the world of academia a much more personal, a much more interesting, and a much more worthwhile place to be. You're not one of many here. You don't get lost in the shuffle.
Often ask me why I have my kids at NEA, because I live on the east end of Alameda, and there's a lot of good schools over there. It's actually a lot of good schools in Alameda, but when I switched my kids 7 years ago, this was one of the only other choices in town, and they always ask me why I did that. And one of the reasons I did that was for the project-based learning. When my kids came here, the freedom that they got, the freedom to speak up, to have an opinion, and to work on projects that they decided they wanted to work on in a way they wanted to work on it, was a gift to them. They never thought about switching back. They've loved it since they started. And that's the reason I keep my kids here, is because they're happy, and when they're happy, they're learning.
I love NEA because it's very project-based, and I like that the teachers help us adjust to our ability of learning.
And it feels like a really tight-knit community, and we know that everyone loves and supports us.
And they support us with like any ideas that we have.
I feel like we have a voice at our school.
We had a couple buddies 1 year that were in first grade and they had chicks. And it was so cool to watch the chicks hatching and growing. And I thought, you know what? I could do an algebra project with chicks hatching and growing. And so the next year I talked to Mariah about ordering eggs. And so we ordered eggs and then we did this wonderful regression project where the eggs hatched and each group had a chick and they weighed the chick every day and we gathered data and then we talked about whether the chick's growth was more linear or more exponential or more quadratic. And so there was a way to connect math with this thing that they were pretty excited about. I had an experience a number of years, well, a long time ago, where I worked in a different school where there was a script and it was basically a big binder and we had to be doing this lesson on this day. Because that's what all the other teachers who were teaching that level of math were doing. And I didn't go to a school like this.
So Nea is great for my kids because of the project-based learning. They learn by doing projects on the subjects they're learning about. And my kids thrive in that environment. They're allowed to collaborate with other students to come up with answers and work together as a team.
For second grade, one of those projects for me personally has been getting to work on the garden space. I love gardening, and one of our projects is Let It Grow, and having the garden space right out the door this year has made learning just really come to life. We have learners out there going to eat the hummingbird sage. We have learners out there looking for worms. We've started noticing hummingbirds in the garden. There's wildlife that's coming that wasn't there last year, and a lot less weeds and a lot of beautiful plants. So that's one thing for me that just makes Nea so special.
I like Nea because when we have art, we're not just being like, everybody draw an owl and for the feathers, you use ripped off. No. There are different stations, and you can go to all the stations, and you can do whatever you want there using the materials there. And if you have, like, a painting or whatever, then you can go over to the drawing center to draw in the details, and then maybe you can make it into, like, a frame because there's a construction center.
One of the things that I teach here is art, which I love, and last year I implemented a choice-based art program with my third, fourth, and fifth grade. It teaches a lot of responsibility and accountability, and the learners are speaking like artists and making choices for their own artwork, and everyone's doing something different, and it's always fun and amazing. And I think it really is a good model for Nea because it is so much about you bring what you are great at and what you are passionate about to this school, and we'll help you grow that. We're also really concerned about growing people, not just memorizing facts. And so we have our 9 principles that are all about character and creating a good school where people care about each other and where we can all work together and live together.
What kept me at Nea was really the community. We so intentionally build our community, and then it's great to see all those efforts really kind of blossom on their own as kids get involved, as they feel invested in the community and want to offer up different ideas of things that they see that maybe that they could change, or really taking the reins on their own education and how their school is structured.
At Nea, we use a democratic model, and learners are practicing having a voice, which is an important skill when it comes to problem solving, specifically with the use of restorative justice and restorative conversations. Learners really just want to talk to each other and be heard, and that's what creates community.
I feel like we really partner with our families to not only educate the mind, but also to educate the whole child, and really holding us all accountable for maintaining those principles every day and everything we do really makes for a very robust community of people who really nurture children and themselves.
So K through 12, we have learners from every color of the rainbow and every type of background. Together, they can work on projects and different community building activities and events. And what that brings is a real sense of belonging and strong culture. The other thing that I really love about Nea is the fact that I can concurrently enroll up to 50 kids in multiple classes at the college. And so they are actually actively working toward both a high school diploma and a college degree at the same time. Putting that together, we can make our community as diverse as it is, actually fill their needs through their academic challenges and their needs through growing as whole people.
Nea to me means family, and a different type of family than anywhere else I've had before. I feel supported by the community, by facilitators, even by some learners who treat me with equal respect. And I've had learners come to me vulnerable and asking for support, and I absolutely love supporting them. So to me, it means this community, this family that I don't have anywhere else.
I've been with Nea since my sixth grade year. And I think what a lot of people don't realize or appreciate about this school is the sense of safety it has. Like, not just the environment we're in Alameda and all that, but like the teachers and the people. Like, you don't get this, you don't get this type of family sensibility at most high schools. Like, you'll walk by someone you don't even know, but here everyone knows you, everyone wants to support you. There's no harassment, there's no bullying at this school at all. It's been around for 7 years, and that's amazing in and of itself. So this school has really something special. It's small, it's a little banged up a little bit, but it's amazing. It's amazing at its core. Better than all these other schools, definitely.